Our cook-along guest is the feisty queen of Umlazi, Tipcee. The bonafide entertainer has just released a new dance album titled Tipcee The Snyper. Her class act status in the house and dance genre has solidified her in making sure that she's getting these ongoing releases and popular hits in collaboration with some of the country's biggest names. Now let's take a look at some of her popular work. December mode, summer mode, yeah, la la. Now, if you have any questions for Tipcee, head over to our social media platforms using the hashtag Afternoon Express. Welcome back into the loft.
Yeah, yeah. How are you doing?
I'm doing incredible. I mean, every time you come to Afternoon Express, you bring fire, you bring this energy,
girl.
Oh, never. We're not that thing. And it's that thing that keeps people not only tuned into everything that you do, but listening and following onto that music. Mm. Being born and raised in Umlazi, I'm sure your journey with music has been a unique one. I mean, take us through young Tipcee growing up.
Yo, actually, I've always wanted to be a musician, like, since grade seven.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. And as you know, I was in a group called KOC, those four girls. I actually created the group because I've always had that hope, one day I'll become a musician. Mm. So I created the group Chaos, and then Saba under 745 Records.
Mm.
Yeah, and it was like a dream come true, but then it didn't work well, didn't like go well up until I met with Tira.
Right.
Yeah, but she. I've always liked music. I've always wanted to be famous.
So what do you think it was that distinguished you or kind of set you out apart from the other four ladies? I mean, there has to be some strength, tenacity, and that never give up factor that you have.
Yeah, I was a leader, actually. Mm. And I think Sasinga Funi Zete Fanai. Like, some did it for fun, some did it for...
Being popular.
Yeah, but I had passion.
Wow.
That is why I'm going to be like,
But I mean, what do you think it is that Utira, so you see that within yourself, right? But there has to be other characteristics that you think other people might like see in you and feel like, that's my girl. So what do you think it is that Utira saw and the rest of the Afrotainment staple?
The talent, the talent that I have, the passion that I have. I always have something in mind. When I get into studio, like, okay, I don't take a pen and paper and write down.
Wow.
So, Utira, Ubone Logos, this girl is,
There's something in this girl.
Like, please, I want to be an artist.
Yes.
I want to be a musician. I want to be under Afrotainment and stuff. But then he didn't take me seriously up until you heard Ingo Mangaitula Amatata. I think that is when Abona Kona goes, okay, no, there's something in this girl. And then after that, I didn't stop. I did Umalum. And then after, okay, that's in. I'm signing you up. Yeah.
Absolutely. Now, I know Notira is something that is just difficult because he works with so many artists and so many people knock on Tira's door. Do you think that he was just kind of born with that eye for talent?
Yeah, he was. Hits. This is a hit.
Wow.
Yeah, but uganjalo. And I think now when Taiboni like me, it was okay, no, ish.
Yabona lo.
Because it's baningi. Like, Wonkomoji, we all want to be under Afrotainment.
Got the Tipcee. I could easily say that you are the first lady of Afrotainment. You were the first one signed, the first lady holding it down and proudly. And
okay, first it was a Sindo.
Besides a Sindo,
Sindo is a DJ.
Is a DJ,
yeah.
Yes.
So I'm like, Tanzangulu.
Vele, you could say that.
Yeah.
Stunning. And how has the journey been thus far? I mean, you then collaborated with Destruction Boys. You came out with Madness. It was a hit. Everyone was singing along to that melody, that hook. Mm. How did your life change from there?
Yeah, but every time you ask me the question, every time a person asks me the question, I just be like, you know, crying. Yeah, yeah, but it's been a wonderful journey. It's been an absolutely wonderful journey. Obviously, number ups and downs. It's not always straight. Ups and downs. And I'm a challenge. I'm a face. Like at first, be like, I know this girl.
Oh, wow. You know
what I'm talking about.
But why is that? Yeah, I find in the entertainment industry, especially in music, if you have females doing the same thing, then they want to compare you.
Compare.
Yeah, why is that?
So I don't know. It's just females.
Yeah.
It's been a wonderful journey, and I keep dropping hits. Nami and Gizeng Fugus. Okay, no. It's like someone's gonna wake me up again.
Do you think that you ever have that pressure, especially around summertime, around December time? People buy a release. People are wanting to. Everyone wants is going after that title. Mm. Do you feel the pressure? Do you feel that you always need to release these hits, or does it come so naturally to you?
It comes naturally. I mean, I don't feel any pressure. Like. Wow. I don't.
Stunning.
It comes naturally.
Just like that, a bonafide superstar, bonafide entertainer. We've asked you if you've got any questions for Tipcee on our social media platforms. And we've got Umlindo Simli, who asked, what keeps her going in these male-dominated industries? And he used the hashtag Afternoon Express. What keeps you going when you're surrounded by watching or Afrotainment and their strong, heavy male names?
It's loving a studio.
Okay.
Yabo. And we have different artists, yabo. Abo Tira, abashlezi betropa my hits, abo Juice, abashlezi betropa my hits, abo NaakMusiQ, abashlezi betropa my hits, Beast, yabo. So banginika leyo nto ukuthi ish. Okay. Banginika leyo umph, yabo leyo.
Oh wow, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
You're using it as encouragement rather than intimidation.
Yeah, exactly.
Stunning.
Exactly.
Only if a lot of us can learn from that we're not competing, we can all just be on the same level and go for the same goal.
Because even when I studio, like recording, like it's okay, it's about four.
Yeah.
I don't want to start.
Mm.
Yeah, but I don't want to start. I'd say, okay, Beast, start.
Start with the verse.
Tira, start the verse. Because it encourages me.
To add your little something.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, we've got another question here from Uesa. And Uesa says, hey Tipcee, I just can't control it. Your album is more than awesome. I would love to know, which artist would you like to make a collaboration with around Africa? That's a tough one. Africa's huge, yo.
Yeah.
You're looking at, of course, the artists in Nigeria doing big things. East Africa, West Africa, and of course, South Africa. Hello. There's so many names to choose from.
Shoma Josie. Yeah.
Wow. I can see that female power, that little YouTube going at it in the studio
like
back and forth.
Like we could do a hit, baby.
I see that coming summer 2020. Yeah. Well, Tipcee, you're not going anywhere after the break. We're definitely going to be throwing down with you in the kitchen. We're testing out all of your cooking skills and we're putting them to the test with the guidance, of course, of the lovely Chef Zinhle. See you after the break.